In science and technology right now, change is in the air. We're looking at the world in a different way, and quantum physics is fast becoming modern life's most exciting field of study. So much so that when scientists today consider how to advance humankind, they think subatomically. What will the future look like? The answer, it seems, can be found in the invisible world of the infinitely small. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if humanity was a Type 5-minus civilization?
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more fascinating content?
The Kardashev Scale has long been held as the foremost method for measuring societal advancement. Kardashev Type 1 masters all of the energy of its home planet. For Type 2, it's the energy of its home star system. For Type 3, it's of its home galaxy, and so on. But thanks to the theoretical physicist John D. Barrow, there is another way of approaching the problem. In his own work, Barrow uniquely reversed the Kardashev scale into a new system, one that strives for what he called microdimensional mastery. In Barrow's scale, rather than expanding civilizations and ever-increasing units to measure them by, as per Kardashev, success instead comes from mastering increasingly small aspects of reality. At the start of Barrow's list is Type 1-minus, which is any civilization able to master anything their own size or bigger. So anything that's visible, like towns, cities, buildings, rocks, or sand. Then comes Type 2-minus, which relates to anything that can manipulate its own biology, including for organ transplants and gene therapy. And Type 3-minus is able to build new materials out of raw ones by manipulating molecular bonds. The making of plastics is an example of this. So it's so far so good for humankind, we can pretty much do everything on Barrow's scale up until this point. With Type 4-minus, we begin to enter into the unknown, though, as the main requisite for this civilization type is that they've mastered nanotechnology. Today's tech news is awash with headlines about nanotechnology, yes, but we're still far from having complete control over it. In fact, it's a technology sector still very much in its infancy. We took a closer look at this particular level of the Barrow scale in another video, so check that out after this. But next comes the main focus of today's question, Type 5-minus. According to Barrow, a civilization this advanced would be capable of fully manipulating and rearranging an atomic nucleus. They will have zoomed into reality so closely that even the most fundamental building blocks of it are at their mercy. So what would it mean if we could do that? Your first thought might be, hang on a minute, atomic, nucleus, manipulating? Haven't we already done that? And to some extent, we have. The manufacture of atomic weapons has clearly, perhaps irreversibly, changed what it's like to live in this world. And how did we get there? By splitting the atom. By getting to grips with nuclear fission to produce enormous explosions. A Type 5-minus civilization has more to it than city-leveling superweapons, though. Where with A-bombs, it's essentially about the amount of energy that's released when an atom is cut open and the devastating effects thereafter, there's no such threat with Type 5-minus. Or not necessarily, at least. And that's because even at this infinitesimal subatomic level of smallness, they are in complete control. Yes, they could trigger literally any type of explosion at any moment they wanted to, but they're also highly advanced beings, so perhaps they wouldn't be doing that. Consider that every atom is made up of a combination of protons, neutrons, and electrons. The way these are assembled dictates what the atom is, and therefore what it can be used for and combined with in our world. Hydrogen, helium, lead, oxygen, they all have their own unique atomic structure. And when these and other atoms bond together, they form, well, everything. Skyscrapers, spaceships, oceans, forests, our own human bodies. It's all the result of how various atoms are arranged. For Type 5-minus, however, all of that is kind of irrelevant to how they would live their lives. At any time, a Type 5-minus being would be able to precisely change the atoms around them. So we can quickly see how the applications of this would be limitless. Imagine that you're trapped somewhere and you're running out of oxygen. For standard human beings, it's a potential death sentence. But not for a Type 5-minus. They would simply redistribute the atomic nuclei that were at their disposal until, fortunately for all concerned, there is enough oxygen to breathe again. For as long as there are nucleons, i.e. protons and neutrons of some description near at hand, a type 5 minus can engineer the atoms they need. In fact, in the previous scenario, they'd feasibly have a choice. Producing oxygen atoms to re-nourish the body would be one solution. But rearranging their bodies so that they didn't require oxygen in the first place could be another. Although on paper, it does seem as though it would be the harder option of the two. With control over every single atom, and therefore every single molecule, and therefore every single solid, liquid, gas, material of any kind, a type 5 minus would have incredible power from our perspective. As in shape-shifting, produce stuff out of thin air superpowers. They'd be able to walk on water because they'd know how to change the atoms of the water, or of their own feet, to make it so. They'd be able to turn water into wine because ultimately the difference between the two is how they're subatomically put together. They'd also be able to produce pure gold out of seemingly nothing just for the thrill of it. Clark's famous third law says, any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. And that's exactly the situation we'd have here. If a modern human were to meet a type 5 minus being, then their abilities would translate as magic in our eyes. But would there be any wider consequences in an alternate reality where humanity is a civilization this advanced? There's no doubt that microdimensional mastery to this level would have to be controlled, in the sense that it couldn't just be everybody doing what they liked when they liked. Turning a loaf of bread into a stash of diamonds is all well and good, but where does it end? And how quickly before it becomes dangerous? After all, life is predominantly carbon-based. So what would happen if, for example, we began messing with carbon atoms, multiplying, rearranging, or deleting them at will? It might be argued that for this reason, we could claim with some confidence that there aren't any Type 5 civilizations in the universe at present, because the natural world from our point of view seemingly obeys a number of rules. No one, it appears, is rewriting the laws of our reality whenever they feel like it, a feat that would be possible for a Type 5 minus. It might also be argued that if any civilization were to reach Type 5 minus, they'd inevitably have to do so as a collective, perhaps through a hive mind-like setup, or even as just one individual. The powers that they would have would be so all-encompassing that everything else in existence would be inescapably below them. Even for a Type 4 minus society, which, among other things, would employ a theoretical device known as a molecular assembler to manipulate materials above the atomic level. Those guys would still be completely at the mercy of Type 5. And that's because their, by comparison, primitive assembler could only ever work based on the molecules put into it, which would only ever be dictated by the atoms that make them up, which would always be determined by a Type 5 minus. And yet, John Barrow's scale of microdimensional mastery does have two even higher levels, Type 6 minus and Type Omega minus, at which point you're also in complete control of time. Which, considering the scope of abilities possible that we've already seen at Type 5, is pretty mind-blowing. But what's your verdict? Will humankind ever reach these kinds of levels? If we were Type 5 minus, what would you do with all those extra powers? Fans of Barrow's inverted Kardashev scale often highlight a pleasing symmetry between the two systems, because the further along you get with Barrow, the more feasible it becomes to achieve the goals that Kardashev set out. Master something as small as the atoms around you, and suddenly bigger things like space travel become more possible, and megastructures, and perhaps even faster than light speed. It all depends on how far you can zoom in on reality and how firm a grip you can gain over it. Theoretically, it's possible to infinitely change almost everything that exists. And that's what would happen if humanity were a Type 5 minus civilization.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.